Chazak Oponim La'ilam. It shows that it has some connection to world. Is Gamal Zeim Rimshin Iflezer Chayko. Even in the level of tshuva, as tshuva relates to world, it is also on a level of beyond and distant. Vezel, and the Rebbe says, where do we see this in the Aved of a Yid? Vezel Mashamites HaTshuva Hu Inyan V'Ruach Toshav Elokim Asher Nesona. Because the true essence of tshuva is that the ruach turns back, returns to the Eibishter, shalikim the neshama, shalikim asher nesona eine berach klal le'elam bebchinas nefleis urcheikam. Because what does the tshuva accomplish? That he comes back to the Eibishter. The Eibishter who gave the neshama is not within the range of even saying a distance or from world. It's completely a different mitzvah. The Eibishter is shalei be'erech, not even appropriate to say he's distant, he's beyond. It's two different things, two different inyanim. So therefore, this shows that tshuva picks up a person even as it finds itself in this physical world, that it picks up a person to a level which is shalei be'erech higher than world, not within the range even of saying distance. V'zeu gam ma'asheh tshuva bechlal yaveda bebchinas hamakifin shebenefesh. This is also the inyan that the aveda of tshuva is dafka aveda bebchinas hamakifin shebenefesh. The makifim of the nefesh, which is the part of the neshama, which is not in the body. Shebazeh yesh makif dechayi or makif deyechida. Recheiko neflis. In this you have the makif of chaya and the makif of yechida, which are the two levels of the neshama that hover over the body. One is chachma, one is keser. Yechida is always connected with Hashem. Yechida shebenefesh. And Chaya is the union of Chochmah, the union of Bittul. Is Vazem Mechadish because of this is what he is Mechadish, what he stresses in the Pasik. The Masha, Tshuvi, Niflei, Surachek, Ezeo, Legabi, Yahilam. That in the same sense that we mentioned earlier in regards to Teiru Mitzvahs, that it's on a level that's higher than world, not even within the range of world of distance, in the same sense, but in regards to the Jewish nation. It's connected to the Jewish nation that they have the keach and they can actually take teirum mitzvahs and derive halachas in the same sense as regards to the union of tshuva, that on one hand, tshuva is the union of tshurich niflei surecheka. It's a niflei surecheka, which means it's completely removed from world. Zeh olegabe yoelam, this is in regards to world. Omnam benegeh li Yisrael, b'shas, it speaks about the union of Yisrael, which is the union of the Jewish nation. So tshuva is on a level. It's not beyond, it's not removed, not a distance. The avedah on the contrary, that it's close to every person, every person could accomplish it with his mouth and his heart. So Meila, now the Alter Rebbe gets back to the first half of the Maimer, which is V'atu b'nai o b'nai echtichi b'nesa, that you and your children will live b'nesa, what's left over. So what is the leftover? So the Rebbe says there's two things, two points here. V'zeu v'inyin b'ezak tzovis hanal, these are the two extremes. Shebemaimer admur azokin da'atu v'nai echtichi b'nesa, shebetzad echad heimrim shanim shabchina sevav kolol m'nesa. That it's the union of Nesar, which means higher than world. Ki atshuva yikod mele'ilom, because tshuva accomplishes that's higher than world. Shubchina sevav kolom, and it's the union of sevav kolom, which is the revelation of atzmus. There's a difference between mamala kolom and sevav kolom. Mamala kolom sustains world and encloses itself in world, which means takes world in consideration. Sevav kolom and reveals atzmus, which means does not take world at all in consideration. Its function is to reveal atzmus, to reveal higher. So they're two opposite extremes, Sevav Kolom and Mala Kolom. So B'meila, this is what the Rebbe says. On one hand, Sevav Kolom, completely removed from world. Uli Idoch Emrim, on the other hand, we say, Shemizeh Nimshach Chayes Bavidos Shalodah. That in this comes out the Chayes in the Aved of a person. In other words, it is drawn down in the energy of the person. On one hand, beyond the person, on the other hand, it's drawn down and generates chayis in the person. Since the kechas that the person gets from higher than the neshama and the guf generates life and aveda pnimis. Nimshachem b'pnimis hachem nesnim chayis b'avidasi. Till it gives chayis in his aveda. V'atu b'nai yichtich yibanesa. U'kinal ba'arucha, as mentioned earlier, shagam b'chinas shehine fleisu rechek. That even the level that's nefleisu recheka, hine mimach, v'negeel Yisrael, relating to the Jewish nation, av'atu v'nayich, le nefleisim imcha v'le recheka gemen. It's not beyond, it's not distant. V'haynu shemekablim chayis mebchines ha-makifim. Yidin are mekabel the chayis from the makifim, which is higher than the body. It hovers over the body, that part of the neshama, to the extent that it also, on the other hand, it drips, nasal venetef, it drips chayis into the body. As the Rebbe brings in the Ayim Yim in the 24th of Adar, Adar Aleph, that Bishas, the Rabbi Hillel Paritcher, asked the Mittal Rebbe, what is the point of Chazar and Chassidus if the people don't understand it anyway? So the Mittal Rebbe explained that it says, V'nezlim min levonin. It drips from levonin. It's a pasuk in Shir HaShirim. And the Mele says, levonin goes on the Etzem HaNishoma. Lamed Beis goes on the 32 paths of Chochmah. Lamed Beis. Nun are the Nun, 50 gates of Bina. So it says, V'nezlim min levonin. That the Chochmah Bina Shebenefesh it accomplishes from the Etzem HaNefesh, which is higher than the Guf, accomplishes that it's nasal v'netiv, it drips into the Neshama. So although they don't understand, but Lepeil, it drips into the Neshama and it gives keches to the spiritual aveda of the Neshama. Like a person that's getting a vitamin energizer, especially giving keches to the Neshama, and it comes down in mitzvah sese and mitzvah leisese. Positive mitzvahs and as they named it, negative mitzvahs. Hine memach, so he says that b'meila b'negir to yidin, fakert, there's nothing beyond the level of yidin. They reach out and they can draw down from a level which is higher than their limitations. V'yad l'makifim shelemayla megidri makifim pnimi. Till the level of makifim that are higher yet than makifim pnimi. Because when we say makif, it hovers over, that means it's in relationship to something inward, it's considered makif. Ishasa, but you have makifim that are higher than makifim pnimi, so then it's even higher yet than the regular makif. There's a makif that's in relationship to a pnimi. You have the makif, and then you, which it means hovers over, which means there is in contrast to something that's inside. Then you have a level of makifim which is higher yet than makifim pnimi. Higher yet than the structure, the Rebbe says, gidri makifim pnimi. Which means it's not be'erech at all. Let's say an example for that. An example for that would be, again, back to Atik and Arich. Chassidus explains that Arich is a long, is the union of Arichus. Zohar is the abbreviation, acronym, Zeir Anpin, a small image. So Chassidus says, what's the difference? Zeir Anpin is a small image of what Arich Anpin is. Arich Anpin is in Keser, Zeir Anpin is in Atzilus. And what is the comparison one to another? So it's not a comparison in size here. In a quantitative size, it is a comparison in a qualitative size, which means there's a difference between Arich and Zo. Friedrich Rebbe gives him the Friedrich Rebbe in the Maimer, Maimorim Yiddish, explains it is an example of a person that is learning the Halacha. He has the Halacha in Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, in the short abridged version. He has it bekitzer. He has mamish a short psak, a short verdict. Halacha is like this and this, a line and a half. Then he wishes to study the background of the halacha. So he starts learning it in Gemara. Then he learns it in the Tur. And then he learns it in the commentaries of the Tur, the Bach and the Beis Yosef. Then he learns it in the Rambam. Then he learns it in the Rosh. Learns it in the Rif. That goes before Shulchan Aruch, before the Tur. Then he learns it in Alter Rebbe Shulchan Aruch. Then he finally gets a psak din, not only a psak din, but he gets the whole background of the halacha. The whole background is there. What is the difference? The difference is, when he knows the background, it's a different flavor, it's a different light, it's a different chayas. The whole halacha is in front of him. The whole lebedikait of the halacha, the liveliness of the halacha. So the Friedrich Rebbe says, this is the difference between Arich and Zohar. Zohar is a miniature form of what Arich is.